Hello YouTubers. Okay, so we're back to the board as I mentioned in the previous video. After testing with the solar panel attached to the Kindle, I've come back to the board and I've discovered something fairly interesting. I know again one of my viewers was had some input into thinking that the power into charging the supercapacitors wasn't very efficient, and I think I found out why. But we'll go through that just now. What I just wanted to quickly show you and highlight was my Precision Linear power supply has arrived. I've been playing around with it for a little bit and it's absolutely amazing. I'm really impressed with it. So shortly I will be doing a kind of buyer's guide review on that power supply and explain why I decided to buy another variable power supply and the features that it has, which are very useful indeed. So anyway, let's get back to the circuit. What I've done basically, I've got the circuit set up. I've actually got no load connected. I've just got the capacitors charging up. I've set the potentiometer so that it'll come on at 11 volts. And I kind of let it charge up with ample current and then let it discharge, so it cycled again. And what I've done, I've current limited the input current to around 42 milliamp, because that was what I was seeing under real low light conditions and what have you, what I was getting in from the solar panel. So I've done that to kind of cater for a kind of worst case scenario. As you can see, the voltage has been building up, but it has been taking ages. It is really slow now. Now initially when I first started off, what I decided to do was I've got this multimeter obviously tracking the current that's going into the circuit, and then this multimeter is tracking the current which is actually going into the capacitors. Now it initially started off, when I first started, there was about 25 milliamp going in, which I thought, okay, that there's a fair bit of loss, and I realize now why, and it's kind of things relates to what people have been talking about, and that is the what I thought, what was making the circuit nice and simple for me was the relay, 12 volt relay, is actually chewing a fair bit of current, you know, up to 30 odd milliamp, and the consumption increases as the voltage increases, which probably makes sense. So what happens is, so the problem is, which is, it's interesting that as the voltage is building up in the capacitors, there's more current being drawn by that relay, and hence less current available to go into the capacitors themselves. I mean, at 8 milliamp it would take for ages. So I seriously have a bit of a challenge on my hand. But what I'll do just to demonstrate that, how the current change is going into that relay, I'm actually going to disconnect the capacitors so they're out of the circuit. You can see I've actually got the supply was set to 13.5, which is probably roughly 13.5, 14 is what the solar panel would put out. Now as you can see, so there currently there is no load, there is the capacitors are disconnected, and you can see 22 milliamp is what is being drawn. If I drop the voltage, kind of it starts charging around 4 volts is obviously where we start charging, and you can see we've only got 12 milliamp being drawn by that relay. But of course, as I step up the voltage, you can just see it's increasing. It's now up to what, 25, 26. Getting a little bit closer so you can see. And as we start trying to approach the kind of 11 volt volt mark where I've kind of got the relay set to kick in. We're hitting 33, 35. So of course it's just eating all the available current. So either the panel has to be in bright, bright sunlight and be getting kind of close to 90, which out of interest, let's just see what happens if I increase the I'm not going to see until I put a load on. Let's actually just put the connect the capacitors back. So if I increase the available current to around the kind of 85, 90 mark, then as you can see, we were up to what, 40 odd, but it's dropping again as the voltage is increasing. Really are losing current into the capacitors, and the voltage climb on the capacitors is really slow. So that's certainly one of the challenges then, is that relay. So I am going to have to go back, and I know many have made suggestions about, I was playing with FETs and transistors, is using a comparator and a FET. I say, I'm a hobbyist, I'm not an electronics guru, so it's, I'm certainly going to have to do a bit of homework myself and a bit of playing around. But I'll do that because obviously, by the looks of things, I certainly need to make that switching part more efficient, because that is chewing a lot of the useful current that would be coming in from the panel. Anyway, I thought that was an interesting little update. It kind of explained to me why things were really efficient. I was really getting concerned about the solar panel, but it ultimately seems to come down to that little thing over there, that relay. But anyway, thanks again for all your input. Thanks for watching. And if you do enjoy this series, and do subscribe. And I say, soon we'll be doing a review on the precision power supply and also the new oscilloscope that I've got. Thanks very much.